Today's test is going to be brought to you from this rather picturesque location, Rossmoyne on the Canning River in Perth, Western Australia. It's a lovely place, even if its beauty is somewhat blemished by this rather unfortunate example of apostrophe abuse. I've seen quite a few Neo range test videos using radio controllers, but the range when controlled by your phone over Wi-Fi rarely gets a mention. It was originally going to be done here at Shelley foreshore, but I aborted the attempt. I was scaring the birds and was also worried about scaring this cute little old dog. So I packed up and headed down the road. This is the start of my test route. According to the user manual, it's supposed to be 50 meters. I've seen a video where the distance is roughly paced out at 80 meters, and another where the realistic range is stated to be about 30 meters. That's a pretty big variation. I wanted to do some more exact measurements and find out for myself. I measured out a 60 meter course and marked it at 10 meter intervals. Yes, with a tape measure. These yellow gas cylinders at the end of the course are at 50, 55 and 60 meters. The bin back there is at 30 meters. So, let's get testing. Take off. Watch me rather inexpertly use the phone to control this Neo along the course. As I'm doing this, I'm keeping the phone directly above the takeoff point. Meters. 30 meters. 40 meters. 40 meters. Just over the 50 meter marker. Now max flight distance reached. And the Neo comes to a halt. It hasn't actually lost signal at this point because I can still control it to do the landing. As you can see here, it's just got past the 50 meter mark. Let's test it again. I'll speed this one up so you don't have to sit through it. Meters, 30 meters, 40 meters. As before, just past the 50 meter mark, and it comes to a halt. Let's land it again. This time it got just a little bit further at 50.85 meters. Pretty consistent so far, but let's try one more time. This time it's gone a few more meters to 53.3. While I summarise this test, I'm not going to subject you to having to look at my face. Have some more Canning River Neo footage instead, it's much prettier. Here's what I used to do this test. Here's the average distance from the three runs. So, in these tests, the 50 meter Wi-Fi range quoted in the manual seems to be reliably close to the mark. But, big disclaimer coming up, Wi-Fi range can vary for all sorts of technical and environmental reasons. It's probably not wise to stand on the shore and use your phone to send your Neo to land on a pontoon 45 meters away. If you do this, please record it on several devices and upload it because I think it would make a very entertaining video. Bear in mind that the 50 meter range is from the drone to the phone, not to the takeoff point. If you move the phone to follow the Neo, then your range is extended. I've done this following my dog on his walk. Another thing to bear in mind is that the 50 meter distance I measured is a horizontal one. You might think that if you send your Neo up 30 meters and send it off, then you wouldn't get the full 50 meters in horizontal distance. If you could do this, your drone would actually be 58 meters away from you, because that's the length of the hypotenuse of a 50 by 30 triangle. You might think that, and I certainly did, but I was wrong. I tested this exact scenario and found that the horizontal range was identical whether the Neo was at 1 meter height or 30 meters. I have absolutely no idea why. In summary then, yes, 50 meters is a reproducible maximum range for your Neo when controlled by a phone. The manual is right. I hope you enjoyed this video, which is my first attempt to do one of these things. Feedback is very welcome. I'm trying to establish this new channel, so if you feel able to like, comment, share, and most of all subscribe, that would be very much appreciated. Thanks for watching.